Right. What is up, guys? It is Tony, and we're just doing a quick little intro to this track video. Finally getting this car to the track. Right now, we're heading out of the city. If you guys didn't know already, I live in Las Vegas, so I thought, why not shoot while we're going down the strip? It's kind of cool, even though you probably can't see much. But anyway, first time ever taking my own car to the track. I've been to the track before, but I drove a GTR. You guys might remember that video. To be honest, I don't remember much from that experience. But, you know, I have a vague understanding of how to drive on a track. So, you know, I'm going to take it easy, sort of just, you know, play around a little bit, learn. But the main thing I'm going to do, and the main point of this video, and the series of videos, if I do continue to go back, I kind of want to go like once a month or once every few weeks or so. But I want to see what this car really needs. Meaning, I'm really thinking that this car, you know, obviously I want to modify it, but I want to do modifications that are more akin to track work. So that being said, I'm thinking right off the bat, personally, tires are going to be the biggest thing because this thing has all seasons. And for some reason, Chevy put 245s in the back. I don't know why. It actually has a wider section wheel for a wider section tire. So it doesn't really make sense. They kind of stretched it a little bit. But Chevy says it's just, you know, they feel that it's a better experience, that it's more playful. They had a bunch of explanations. That being said, the 1LE V6 has 275s in the rear. So I'm thinking about, you know, changing that setup. And in addition to that, also getting stickier tires in the rear. Because I've noticed this car does like to give a little bit of wheel spin from a dig, which is surprising for a V6. But it's probably just because it's lighter. You know, weight is a big component in traction, especially from a dig, especially in the rain, especially in any situation where your wheels are sort of raised up from the asphalt. You know, weight kind of pushes you down. So anyway, I don't know why I'm going into this, but point is, I kind of want to see what this car needs. All right, well, I'll see you guys at the track. Oh, good job. Look what you've done. All right, I'll see you guys at the track. So we're getting there. We're on the highway right now in the middle of the desert. I thought I'd film a little bit while the sun's coming up. It looks pretty beautiful. I don't know where Isaac went. He's behind me somewhere. Oh, here he comes. He's speeding up, finally. But yeah, we're heading out there. Thought I'd film a little bit. All right, so as you guys can see, it's a lot brighter out now. We're a lot closer. We're actually like 70 miles away as opposed to 160. But me and Isaac were, this BMW is trying to keep up with me. But me and Isaac were kind of holding pretty decent speed, and his turbo just gave out. It just gave out of nowhere. So I think it's like overheating or something. He said he's gonna try to let it cool down while he just cruises. But I'm gonna try to, I'm pretty far ahead of him now because I didn't even realize, because I wasn't really looking at my rear view. I'm gonna try to find a stop here somewhere. But I thought I'd film and just document this because it was pretty interesting. It's pretty funny, honestly. But I was just saying to him, I prefer naturally aspirated, and this is why. Reliability. Even though my car broke down a lot. Like, last time we went to go to the track, the reason why we didn't go is because my car broke down. But it didn't really break down. It was having, like, computer issues. Like, Chevy just did a poor job. Jeez. Chevy just did a poor job with the ECU. They completely redesigned it, and because of that, it just wasn't very reliable. But, yeah, I'm gonna try to find a stop here, and, probably next time I record, we'll be at the track, so there you go. All right, so this is the part where I tell you guys with a voiceover what I did wrong. So basically, this is a clip of Isaac, my friend, going around the track. First go in his Fiesta ST of the day. And as you can see, the GoPro angle is awful. Absolutely awful. At least you can see him shifting and stuff, which is something you guys normally don't get on my channel because I'm a noob and I bought an auto. So that's pretty cool. But that being said, I'm talking over it because this is going to transition into a clip that is, you know, terrible audio. But I wanted to include it anyway because it kind of gives you some backstory of what's going on. And there's like a funny moment where I can't get my helmet on because my hair is blowing everywhere. So I don't know. I thought maybe you guys would, some of you guys would enjoy it. But basically, I want to explain a little bit here. I followed him to go onto the track with no helmet on. I was not ready to go at all. Like, I had crap in my car I had to, like, put in the trunk and secure. And he was, like, staging up to get on the track. But he told me that he was just going to move up, like, move up, you know, in the pit area or whatever. And, yeah, it was kind of awkward. So I had to, like, reverse back through the pit area. And there's one point where I, like, explain that. So if you guys are wondering what that's about, there you go. But right after this, we're going to go right into the Camaro doing some track work and then back to his car with a better angle. So enjoy.
Sounds awful, dude. It really does. Like, it's making the weirdest noises.
Oh, well.
I was connected to you a second, and I hit record. I wonder if it actually recorded.
Well, doesn't really seem to impact the driving.
Dude, you said, like, earlier you said, like, I'm gonna move up. So when we went, I thought you were just moving up. And you took me all the way there, and I was like, oh shit, I can't. Shit, go on track.
Oh, I did. Whoops. You love that smell of burnt tire? Dude, I don't know what I did to my car. It's okay.
Look at your coolant.
It does that. God, I don't fit with the helmet on.
Well, go back. Let me move these pretzels.
No, I'm fine. Are you recording?
Oh, yeah. I recorded it.
Okay. Wait, move the seat back. No. You're good. Get a feel for the track before you start going really fast.
These turns are so tight.
back end's loosen up. Oh god, that was, Tony, please.
That one's, I always forget about that one.
Better break yeah. Early than late.
Yeah, definitely. I'm just super cautious.
This is your only car. Content or your car gives up.
I feel like the tires are already starting to get hot. This time, late. There we go. Not too late.
Oh god. Are you gonna go for another one? Oh shit!
Dude, the last one's always the worst. It's a fact.
It's true for movies too.
So, we're gonna go get gas. So this is a cool part about this track, is to get here, which I didn't film on the way in, but I'm filming it on the way out, I guess. There's this awesome dirt road, which is kinda crazy in this car. Like, even the smallest bump is just hectic. I will admit, though, this is a lot better than the old Camaro, jeez, was on dirt roads like this. The old Camaro, from my memory, oh great, he's getting mud on me. From my memory, the old Camaro was super stiff, but this has a Cadillac suspension in it, the ATS suspension, which is a little bit nicer, a little bit softer, but kind of helps out in situations like this. But we're going to go get gas. He's running low on gas. I'm kind of running low. Has a big tank. This car has like a 17, 18 gallon tank. But this was really fun. I had a few laps. I guess I'll give my thoughts real quick. Got to admit, I think the tires are its biggest detriment. It's just, you don't feel like you have the traction you want ever. That's like the number one flaw. Like, power-wise, this car, especially for this track, it's a very tight track, this car has more than enough power. In fact, I find myself running out of road a lot of the times when I really want to just rev it out. So this car, for tighter tracks, for sure, is definitely powerful enough, which is not surprising. I mean, Everyone bags on the V6s, which makes you think they're gonna suck. But I mean, 0-60 in 5.1 is pretty quick. But anyway, let's go get gas, and we'll do a few more laps, and we'll probably just cut back to that. But there you go.
Coming out of the corners, you don't really have a lot.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.